Ah bah, là on est bien en Irlande, hein, il y a un petit grain. We are well in Ireland, just a quick shower. Quick shower, we are in... Ah, Robert is here. We are in Yeomanstown Stud Farm with Robert O'Callaghan. So it's an important and traditional Irish stud farm, focus on the speed. Can you explain all your activities here? C'est un grand haras traditionnel basé sur la vitesse, mais qui fait beaucoup, beaucoup de choses ici à Yeomanstown, Robert.
Well, basically, yeah, we breed foals or racehorses every year. We have about broodmare band of about 70 mares with our three stallions, Dark Angel, Camacho, and Gudafan. We breed to sell as yearlings, so we breed about 60-65 every year, and we buy about 15 to 20 foals every year as well. So we'd have between 70 and 80 yearlings to prep and sell, and then we'd, after the yearling sales, we'd have about between 12 and 20 horses to sell at the breeze ups, and then we'd race three or four every year. So we kind of are all levels of the industry, kind of doing our best to provide.
Ah bah voilà, c'est un haras irlandais typique, c'est-à-dire qu'ils font plein de choses. Ils ont à peu près 70 poulinières et ils vendent toute leur production, ce qui n'empêche pas d'acheter 15 à 20 yearlings par an et aussi de préparer des chevaux pour les breeze-up. Il y a trois étalons ici que nous allons découvrir dans quelques instants, bien sûr avec la superstar Dark Angel. Alors contrairement à la France, les gris sont très très rares. Les étalons gris sont très très rares en Irlande. Opposite to France, there is just a few grey horse, grey stallions in Ireland, but a superstar one called Dark Angel. So Dark Angel is a very special case.
Oh, he's very special to us. Like, we bred him ourselves here, and we sold him as a yearling to Barry Hills for 62,000 at Doncaster Premier Yearling Sale. Bought him back then in September as a two-year-old career after he won the Group 1 Middle Park. As a two-year-old, which was kind of, it's probably one of the first stallions retired too, but he thought he'd fit the bill at the time, and thank God he's worked out for us. He's been very special for us, and it's been a very fairy tale story.
So, alors, c'est un cheval très particulier parce qu'ils sont très attachés à Dark Angel. Il est né ici. Ensuite, il a été vendu au Doncaster Premier Sale for 62. Ça fait 62 000 pounds à Barry Hills. Il a gagné les Middle Park Stakes et il a été retiré à la fin de son année de 2 ans. So, since he retired, NAR is standing for 60,000 euros. What explained this fee?
Well, so he went in, I think, at 12,000 originally. And he was well supported, and then he dropped to 10 and 8 in his kind of second and third years to get more mares. And then when he kind of just kept progressing, he kept his every crop every year kept getting better and better. He had in his first crop, he had Group 1 winner Lidl Force, who won the July Cup and Diamond Jubilee. So then from then on, it just went up and back from 8 up to 12.5 to 15 to 27.5 last year. And then he last season, 2015 season, he just had an unbelievable. He had 14 individual stakes winners of 20 stakes races, including Mecca's Angel, who won the Group 1 Nunthorpe.
Alors donc il est parti en fait à 12 000 livres si je me rappelle bien, donc comme un étalon comme un autre on va dire ici, mais dès sa première génération il a sorti Lethal Force, gagnant de groupe 1, et puis après encore des gagnants de groupe 1 dont Mecca's Angel, donc son prix a monté pour atteindre cette année les 60 000 euros. So Dark Angel is a star of Yeomanstown, and now he has a son, a very young son. He's only turning 3 now. Dark Angel, c'est l'étalon vedette de Yeomanstown. Il a un fils gris également qui vient de rentrer à l'âge de seulement 3 ans. He's Gutifan. Can you explain why Gutifan was retired at the end of the 2-year-old season?
Well, the last couple of years it's been very hard to buy a new stallion. Just with between Qatar, Ashikab, Coomore, and Darley, it's just getting harder and harder to buy these stallions. So Gudafan was put to us, or we were able to get him, and we were in dire need of a new stallion, so it was more beneficial to us to retire him this year than to race him as a three-year-old. Although I'd love to see him race his three, like Dark Angel's progeny only get better as they get older, so but hopefully he'll be just like his sire and he'll do just as well.
Bah en fait, c'est de plus en plus difficile de trouver des étalons avec la grande concurrence et la nouvelle concurrence des Qataris. D'ailleurs, Qataris, sous les couleurs duquel courait Gutifan, hein, gagnant du Robert Papin et deuxième du Morny. Et bon, ils ont eu l'opportunité de trouver ce fils de Dark Angel, et comme ils cherchaient vraiment un étalon, eh bien, ils l'ont rentré dès son début de 3 ans, même s'il dit, ah, c'est un petit peu, il aurait pu courir, parce que quand on voit la production de Dark Angel, ils sont précoces, mais plus ça va, plus Lethal Force, par exemple, a couru à 4 ans et à 5 ans. Mais bon, en tout cas, Gutifan est rentré dès cette année, à l'âge de 3 ans, comme étalon, aux côtés de son père, Dark Angel. Alors, ici à Yeomanstown, il y a Dark Angel le Gris, Gutefan, le fils de Dark Angel le Gris, mais aussi un cheval qu'on connaît bien, un cheval d'âge qui s'appelle Camacho, un vrai sprinter. Here there is Camacho, completely different than the others, but he's also a sprinter. Camacho is a really proven sire.
He is. He's as Boy Dane Hill, who was one of the best stallions ever. He's really proved himself. When he gets the chance, he can really do something for your mare. He's done wonders for Owen Mares. He's put winners of Black Type into everything, and he's probably one of the best value out there in Ireland as regards a proven stallion. He only stands at 7,500, so like it's very little risk for what you're getting.
And he comes back. He was in England. That's it.
He went to England there 2 years ago to Mickley Stud to Richard Kent, who owns a share in the horse. He offered to take him. We said we'd explore a new route. We were struggling for mares, so we explored a new route, and then he took off. Then he got a nice crop of mares just before he went, and that they took off, so he came back, and he's been very popular ever since.
Alors c'est un bon cheval Camacho, un cheval solide, un cheval sérieux, un fils de Dan Hill qu'ils ont acheté à Yeudmont Farm, qui prend de l'âge, mais c'est un bon ouvrier. C'est un cheval qui améliore des juments, souvent de classe inférieure. Il est établi à 7500 euros. Voilà, il produit des vainqueurs. Et au point qu'ils l'ont ramené ici, le cheval était parti passer 2 ans à Mickley Stud en Angleterre. Et puis il est revenu pour continuer son œuvre, pas dans l'ombre, mais à côté de Dark Angel, donc le sprinter Camacho.